Wearing a fox on glasses.
I don't think anybody's really made a profession out of, quote, cutting letters out as a sole means of support. I mean, you do other things, you paint, you design, you silkscreen, you know, it's all to do with signs, but I've created kind of a niche.
So yeah, I'm going to cut this P out, but first of all, before I cut the P out, I'm going to cut the inside out, because when I put it on the bandsaw again, I'll have all this to hold on to instead of just a little bit.
Okay, so first you drill a hole.
Through the hole. And the two ends are going to come together up here. And you're done.
In the beginning, I needed a job, a summer job, and my dad, who was an insurance adjuster at the time, had a claim down at his cardboard factory, and they needed summertime help. So I went down, he got me a job taking cardboard boxes off of a conveyor belt. And one day the foreman says, "Hey, listen, can you operate a bandsaw?" I said, "Well, if you show me, I can do it." And he showed me. And the foreman says, "Man, you're really good at this, you know. Because I'm going to take you off the line and put you on the bandsaw." And then about 10 years later, I'm working in a sign shop. And I've got bandsaws. And the boss says, "You think you can cut these letters out?" I said, "Sure." "Hey, you're really good at this." So here I am, I found a home. Well, there's not many of us out there. I guess in different parts of the country there are some that I don't know about, but around here in the Bay Area, most of the cutout letters and logos and such are cut by water jet or laser. But I'm still competitive with those guys. You go out and see letters and you can tell by looking at whether it's a good job or not. If it's a good job, how are they made? Maybe it was a whole different process than you're doing or you're used to. So you just try to figure out, you know, how is that done? Can I do that? Or can I incorporate that into what I do? Had a few nicks, cut my thumb a few times, cut my finger a few times. Nothing's major.
No, that's pretty good. Let's see how the edges are.
We can make that better with the sander.
If you're doing 50, 100 of these things, you do all one operation at one time, and then you go on to the next operation, and then you go on to the next operation. So you can do about 8 an hour.
About 1/4 inch brass.
I just rubbing it on some sandpaper.
Sweeping the floors, open up the doors, here, turn on the lights, getting ready for the night.
Come out with a nice finish.
Nobody's dramatic cause it's too early for dancing, but here comes the music.
There you are.
Bright lights flashing, the cover of the lacquer. So many people, so many problems, so many reasons to find another round. We could dance to another night on the town. With the big man, only man, better than the other man. He got the plan with the $1 million give a damn. When nobody understands, become a smaller man, the bright lights keep flashing.